Hello, welcome back to Going Walkabout. In this Flutter episode, I start working on the edit of the profile. So before we get into the actual implementation, I first want to show you what is the goal, what I want to achieve. I'm going to show that here on my phone, what is the iOS version of the app where I have it already working. Today, we'll focus on Flutter, but I'll show you what I want to achieve. So we go to the profile, and in the profile, we press the edit on the top right corner. And we have a default profile image with the pencil we can browse through. We can select a new image. I select one. I can, you know, drag it around. I can pinch to zoom, and I can get the correct, let's say, framing I want to have. If I save now the picture, this will be my new profile image. So it's very simple. Pick an image, do a little bit of dragging to position it correct, zoom it a bit, save it, crop it, store it, done. Now, this is what I wanted to achieve in Flutter. And I have been using image pickers. I have the normal image picker and the multi image picker, and I use them both in the product, and neither of them are really, really great. But I'll get to that in a minute. Let's first start with the basics. So here in my normal profile page, I implement the show profile edit function. That is called here in the button on the action, the app bar, the edit button, and that show profile edit, it will create my profile edit block, and then it will my profile edit view. In the profile edit block, it's very simple. I won't go into the details because I have explained these blocks a lot, but it's just to frame the basics of the application. So I have a name in the bio here. With the streams set up, I get my data, so I query the user repository for the user. If it's successful, I set it, otherwise it's empty. And I refresh, get my data. The check data function will then update the stream, and that will re-render the screen. Now, if we go to the screen, what is taking care of all the rendering, we will already see a get image, but I'll get back to that in a minute. We built the view. We give it a title, we have a flat button on top where we can save it so that we can save our changes. And I have created a couple of widgets already that I've shown before that I can make iOS-like forms that were still from the time when I tried to really replicate my iOS application. Now, those forms, this works. And this, if we look this into the emulator, go to the profile. We can press the edit button, we get the dialogue, and we get the name and the bio. But we don't get the picture editor. That is the next step of the application where it really got tricky to a point where I, for a moment, didn't feel like continuing the project anymore. I'll show you why I thought that was the case. So the next step is implementing image picker. Which one shall I take? The image picker, the multi-image picker, those are the two that are used the most and the, let's say, most commonly used image pickers. Actually, I haven't found any alternative that is better than those two, and those two aren't very great. So let's go and get to that part of the code. So here we are again in the edit view, and what I did is I implemented here two functions, because just to show you how they look, I implemented actually both of them. So we had the get image, what is using the image picker that is maintained by the Google Flutter team. So it links to the native image picker in iOS and Android, and you get that, and it works. It's ugly as hell, cannot be customized, and it doesn't support a multi-image picker. In this scenario, that is fine, but in other scenarios, I would like to pick multiple images at the same time. I also implemented the multi-image picker that is a Flutter wrapper around two widely used components, one in Android and one in iOS. It looks reasonable. It has two limited customization options to fit it the brand that you want to have. And the single image interface is not very logical. So for multiple images, it's okay, but still not great. So I tried to do a little bit of customization on the thing. Now you see this works. I can change the action bar color, but I cannot change the color of the text. So I had difficulties fitting it into my branding. I implemented both. So in my user interface here, where I start showing in my list view an image here with container where I do the box decoration circle. So to create the circle image with 200 and picture images, you stack that with two pencil buttons. In my eyes example, you saw one pencil button. Now we have two pencil buttons just to show you the two pickers and how they behave and how they look at. So let's go and have a look at those first before we continue looking into the actual implementation of both of them. But first, we need to see how they look like so that you can understand why am I a little bit frustrated at the moment with these image pickers. Okay, we have the app running, so let's go to the profile. Let's click on the edit. And there we are, we have an image. Okay, the image is not stored correctly. It's a little bit of a detail. Let's click on the top one. What is the image picker? And to be honest, I'm completely lost now. Maybe the Android people, they understand this kind of behavior. But for me, where is my app? And where are my images? And I need to go to photos, then I need to wait a while, I need to go to my downloaded folders, and now I get the gallery, and I haven't figured out how I can get to this page immediately. I just want to pick an image, and I don't want to get all this other stuff around it. I can close it, then I still need to go back, yeah, and drive photos. I just don't understand. So let's pick a photo. It disappears and it has selected my photo here. I don't think it's a very smooth transition, but okay, I can live with that. Now let's go to the next one. We go here, and this is already a little bit more as a photo picker. It's still not great because I would like to have, you know, all the recent images, because in most of the cases you want to see the recent images, and I can go here and now I get my grid. Now the problem is that if I start select and I, you know, because I set the maximum number, so I can select this, it closes and it will update my image. So neither of them is great. Both are a little bit weird. And in both cases, there, I don't know what it is, but it's not part of the application. So this is my main frustration with these image pickers, and that is also a little bit of reason why maybe I need to build something myself. But on the other hand, I looked at the implementation of the current one, and that is using a lot of files and temp files and then trying to clean those up again. And anyway, I'm digressing. Let's go into the rest of the stuff to deal with that. Now, in my blog, I have called a function here somewhere, update image. So in the first situation where I use the normal image picker, I have a file. I read the file, the bytes. I put the bytes in my block. I delete the file because it works on temporary files. So I have the bytes, I store them in memory. I delete the file, I check data, put it in the stream, and it gets re-rendered. Now, in the situation of the multi-image picker, I get a list of assets, and if that list is one, well, it will be, because it could be zero. Anyway, I get the thumb, and that is an advantage because I can get immediately a resized version of the image, so less bytes to store. I get that, and I just need to store it in byte data because that's what it returns, and I can convert that to the image data this way, check the data, and render it on the screen. So the result of both is that I get the image data and I can render it. And then in my profile, my edit, here, if I have image data, so if it's not null, then I use the memory image to render the data image that comes from my block. Otherwise, I use the default user image that I had with the trip images and I explained in a previous episode. So this is all okay, it works, and I get the render. And then in the edit, I can update the user. Well, we already updated the user in the database. If that is successful, and if we have an image, we create image data. And this is the thing, because I implemented an image cache, and there's other episodes about explaining about that. So I have an image, I first store it in my cache, and the cache will take care of synchronizing it to the cloud. And I've done that so that I have better offline capabilities in the application. So all I need to do here is edit actual to my cache, and then the cache, call the cache synchronize, that will try to synchronize if there's connection and deal with all that stuff behind. That's not new, that already existed for trip images, and it's the same for user images, only the path where they get stored in the cloud is different, but it's the same. And that media cache here works on byte data, that's why I need to convert that. And this is a little bit of a, you know, I don't like, because I first converted from byte data to an image list, then back, and depending on which image picker I'm going to use on the long run, I will refactor this so it uses the data storage format of that particular picker so that I don't have to copy those bytes too many times. Now, I haven't gotten to, you know, the zooming and the dragging and all that stuff. That's for a next episode, I guess, if I find back some motivation, because I'm also considering of throwing it all away or either take a break or go and build a image picker that works the way I want. I want to pick images, see the recent images in a nice grid and go. But apparently that's not existing at the moment. So I either have to take what there is, or have to build it, or have to stop the project. I haven't decided it yet, but I would like to get your recommendation or feedback on that. So I'll thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.